this is going to be a real democratic liberal society per Western models, because we are no less than the West. You know, we deserve to have a real democracy too, and we don't deserve to have a Taliban type of a government. You know,
but the West doesn't have a very good track record, does it, when dealing with what are essentially sectarian disputes?
Not only that, I agree with you totally. Look at Iraq; is a mess today. Libya, total mess. Benghazi is now the headquarters of Al-Qaeda and their sympathizers. You know, okay. So Libya is a mess. I would say, okay, actually Egypt is Egypt stands up to be the best in terms of all this turmoil, you know.
Now, you have $1 billion or so invested in Egypt right now. Where else are you looking to invest, and how soon?
I would like to concentrate in Egypt right now, because I think the country, first of all, is in need. We need to show the world that the Egyptians are investing in Egypt, because if we don't invest in Egypt, we can't ask foreigners to come and invest in Egypt. I am extremely positive on Egypt in general. I mean, you need to make a visit and to see how happy the people are now. It's like people, you know, I've been there during these events, and I've seen the people on the street. They were like singing and cheerful. We've lost our sense of humor for 2 years, you know. People were like totally in depression. People were trying to relocate to Dubai, everywhere, because of that. But nobody wants a religious, fascistic...
But if everyone's so happy, how do you explain the violence of the last few weeks?
No, the violence was orchestrated by the Muslim Brotherhood and the militant groups that are associated with them, the jihadis, Al-Qaeda, all these people.
And how soon you is that going to go away?
It's finished. I mean, right now, if you watch the news in Egypt, it's gone.
So right now, you're looking to invest in Egypt specifically?
I would invest in Egypt in, under any case, as long as we have a good governance, as long as we're going the right way, we'll have democratic elections for parliament and for the president. There is no doubt in my mind that we're going in the right way, and therefore I would invest immediately, you know.
And what sectors?
Finance, so microfinance. I think industrial agriculture, like sugar factories and any industrialization of agriculture. Even agriculture, I would like to invest. You know, we have a little bit of scarcity in the land, but there are other areas where you can. Real estate, and of course my baby, telecom and internet, you know. So I would think on all these areas. You know.
The Muslim Brotherhood did make a major push to bring in private investment, international investment. Some of the heads of the largest private equity groups in the world were in Cairo over the last year and a half, and we're seeing them still hesitant to invest in Egypt. What would you say to them?
No, well, at that time that they didn't invest, it was the right choice, because I wouldn't have put a penny with these people. Because they have no clue on how to run an economy, how to run a country, and they have a religious agenda, you know. And they went against, let me tell you, the president, you know, he went against my family, targeted. He targeted my family, he targeted me. Okay, when you do that, you need to also expect a reaction, you know. And I'm not the kind who...
You were criticized for paying those taxes.
It's not me. I would have never paid a penny. That was my brother and my dad, you know. They are peaceful. Me, when you shoot at me, I go forward. I shoot one bullet, I shoot 10 bullets, you know. So by targeting this family, which is half the Cairo Stock Exchange, the largest employer in the country and the largest taxpayer, okay, you are sending the wrong signals to the investors.